Hello, this is Chris Beasley, and in this video today, we're continuing our series of introducing features for Echem Analyst 2. And today, what I want to introduce to you is a function that allows you to deconvolute EIS data that could be useful for helping to determine what models to use for your equivalent circuit fitting. This function is called distribution of relaxation times, and I'll walk you through two specific examples to show you the results that you might get from this. But if you want a more detailed explanation of what DRT is, I would suggest you go to any of the reviews or the papers in the literature. So when you open a standard electrochemical impedance spectroscopy file in Echem Analyst 2, you click on the impedance menu, and you'll see there's a function called distribution of relaxation times. You click on that, there's a window that pops up, or a dialog box that pops up. You can click auto fit right away, or you can click the advanced button and go through changing a series of parameters that you feel confident changing. Again, I'll leave those to you to research more to understand what those parameters are, so that you can make the best determination for your results. I'm just gonna click on auto fit. The window goes away. It performs a fit on your data. And this is a standard Randall cell. That's our dummy cell that is included with the potentiostat. And you can see it added a tab to the end here. And really what this does is this is showing that there's one time constant with from our data that we acquired. It lists a number of other parameters that were used in this fitting, and it also lists a table of results here that is essentially the plot that you're seeing on the right. So if we look at a slightly more complicated spectrum, I'm going to load up data from a dye sensitized cell where there's multiple time constants that we're going to deconvolute, and hopefully this allows you to have a better starting point for your data analysis. Now you can see here in this Bode plot, it's much more complicated than the standard Randall cell that we just looked at. It's hard to determine how many RC time constants you might have from this these data. Again, we can look at the Nyquist plot here. It looks like there's probably three, but as we all know, if there's time constants that are overlapping, it gets really hard to make an estimate of just how many there are. So we're going to go to the impedance menu, click distribution and relaxations time here, and I'm just going to click auto fit once more. I'm not going to change any of the parameters. Looks like we got a pretty good fit to start. If we click on DRT, we can actually see there's probably six or seven RC time constants that we're able to see here. So anyway, this is a new feature that we had added to Echem Analyst 2, and we're really excited about it. We think this could be useful for a lot of people. So I would encourage you to look through the literature, make sure you understand this before you get started on it. It's a really powerful technique. It gives you a lot of information, but at the same time, it's make sure that you understand it when you use it. Anyway, we'll continue our series of videos about features within Echem Analyst 2. Thank you for watching.